there. Yeah.
Early in the morning, late at night. It don't even matter what time it is. President Roller, RM, wait. Whenever I found time, it's okay.
ATL, Jacob.
You pray for my demons, girl, I got you. Every time I sip on codeine, I get vulnerable. Annoying the sounds of the storm when it comes. She understand I can't take her everywhere a nigga going. I've been in the field like the children of the corn. I can hear your tears when they drop over the phone. Get mad at yourself cause you can't leave me alone. Gossip and messy, it ain't what we doing. Traveling around the world, over the phone dropping tears. I get more vulnerable when I do this. When you drunk you tell me exactly how you feel. When I'm loaded, I keep it real. Need to tell a real one exactly what it is. Don't say it cause you know that's why I wanna hear.
Yeah, I've been trapping around the world. I sit on my balcony and wonder how you're feeling. I got a career that takes my time away from women. I cannot convince you that I love you for a living. I be on your line, feelings flowing like a river. You be texting back, you and Kiki on the river. Message say deliver, but I know that y'all don't get it. Why you introduce us if you knew that you was with him? Made me shake his hand, we all been fucking for a minute. Walk me off the plane because you know that I'm a swimmer. Supposed to be a dog, but you done put me in a kennel. Girl, put a muzzle on it, all that barking over dinner. I was fucking with you when you had a tiny presidential. You got better when you met me, and that ain't coincidental. Tried to bring the best out you, guess I'm not that influential. Guess I'm not the one that's mad for you. I can hear your tears when they drop over the phone. Get mad at myself cause I can't leave you alone. Gossip and messages, that ain't what we doing. Yeah. Trapping around the world.
Check, check, 1, 2. Check, check, 1, 2. What up? You listen to the BirdHouse Show. I'm your host, Jay Bird. I got my man, Big Mo, in the house with me. What up, Mo?
What it do?
You know, another edition.
Yeah.
That was New Future featuring Drake, as usual, you know what I mean? Let me see where you at. Let me see if I can see, figure where you at. Okay, yeah. What up? So we're here, man. So check this out. Tell me some of the shows since the last time we met that you've been watching. We can get some of our fans to join in with us.
They probably I've been watching FBI. Mostly like the series. They got like three different ones. So it's like regular FBI, then it's like over there, UK FBI, then there's another one. I forgot the name of it. FBI Underground.
Okay.
So I've been trying to like get caught up on all of those. I watched all of, you know, all the new movies that came out.
Like what? Give me one of your favorites.
I don't have one.
Give me one of your worst ones.
That Morbius.
You watched that?
Yeah, this shit.
I couldn't do it, but tell me like I couldn't do it. I couldn't do it.
You know, you gotta try to keep up with the Marvel Universe.
Yeah.
If that's who you are, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. So how much of the Marvel Universe are you actually caught up with?
Damn near all of it.
You caught up. Did you watch like Marvel What If?
No.
Okay. Did you watch Falcon and the Winter Soldier?
I watched that.
Okay. And the reason why I asked about the Marvel What If is because I believe in episode 7 or 8, there's an episode that ties into the newest Spider-Man that just came out.
Right.
And the new Doctor Strange.
See, that's about to drop.
But without that Marvel What If,
right,
some of that stuff wouldn't make sense. So
this last one didn't make sense.
Which one?
Graphics? Beautiful.
Yeah, on Morbius, right?
Yeah, beautiful. Storyline, terrible.
What about Moon Knight? Did you watch Moon Knight?
Did I watch Moon Knight? Who is that?
Moon Knight is the latest Marvel drop that is on Disney Plus.
No, can't watch it. If anything on Disney, you know I can't watch it. I don't watch Disney.
Well, you're the Fire Stick King.
Yeah, but I don't be on Disney Plus.
Okay, I got you. Well, that's where all of the Marvel shit is.
Well, I got to, I got to add up to
it. Anyway. Man, they got a lot of Marvel stuff, man. I'm telling you, because I didn't even watch them all.
Right, because I'm saying, like, that's thrown out. Now you got to catch up on this side and this side, you know what I'm saying? Because it's...
So where we at? Do you know where we are with the, like, the Black Panther saga?
I know they're supposed to be dropping a new one. I don't know. I ain't heard nothing else.
I'm still waiting, man.
They like, 2023?
Because I just recently saw a trailer for the new Thor.
I seen a trailer for the Black Panther.
You saw a trailer for the Black Panther?
Yeah.
I gotta watch that shit. I ain't seen it.
Yeah, sister, you know, she taking over.
I saw the new Doctor Strange. I saw the new Thor. You know, it's a female now.
No.
Thor is a female now. And it's not the Valkyrie neither.
Is it the chick that was on the...
No.
You know what I'm talking about? The one that was on the horse?
No, this bitch is a straight Viking. Like a, I don't know what you call them. She like a Scandinavian chick, blonde, blue eye, you know.
Yeah, okay.
Like 100%. You know what I'm saying? I think Spider-Man for the PlayStation got pushed back. I think the new one, I think that got pushed back. But other than that, in the Marvel Universe, I think, you know who's in the new Thor though?
Who?
The Guardians of the Galaxy. Because I think they got a new one coming out, and I think that Batista stepped off.
Yeah, no, because it don't make sense.
You know what I'm saying?
They're really not the big names. You know what I'm saying? Like, we got to get to the big names. We got to get back to the Avengers.
And now it's almost like we got to start over for real. You know what I'm
saying? Yeah, because of the endgame. Y'all, we need another Avengers.
But you know that they're trying to tie in from Sony, the movie company, and the Disney company. Now they're trying to pull in like the Fantastic Four. They're trying to pull in the X-Men. They're trying to pull in it's somebody else. I don't want to say Deadpool just yet, but I wouldn't be surprised.
Well, name a weak move the X-Men's made.
But they weren't as good as the comic books though.
Well, I'm just saying, name a weak movie though.
I can't.
You really can't.
The Last Stand was the hardest. But you know what? Do you know which one was whack though? But it wasn't exactly an X-Men title. Dark Phoenix.
Dark Phoenix was nice. I like Dark Phoenix.
I didn't like the villains in that shit, man.
Yeah, the villains was corny, but her.
Oh no, she's the shit. You know what I'm saying? But let me ask you. So, did you watch the Eternals?
Yes, I did.
Did you like it? I didn't watch it. I had to suspend. See, listen. Let me tell you what I did. I didn't try to watch it. I was already biased because I knew that you couldn't do much. I was a real comic book person. After the Avengers, knowing that the Endgame and all of that shit was not what should have been Secret Wars. Mm-hmm. Now they're gonna work on Secret Wars. But when I saw The Eternals, I watched the first like 10 minutes. And do you know what I saw? What? You know what I saw in the first 10 minutes?
What?
They can do anything. And I just stopped watching it because I'm like...
Not really.
And pretty much they could do anything.
No. No, because one of them, they was getting two. Did two of them die? I think two of them died, or one of them died for sure. Two of them died.
Really?
Yeah.
See, I only got past the first 10 minutes.
But I'm saying, like, Icarus mm-hmm. is the strongest one.
Right.
The rest of them ain't really that strong. You know what I'm saying? So, like, you gotta watch this shit, man.
All the way through?
Yeah, I mean, it's not bad at all.
No, I don't think that it's probably not bad. It's just that...
It's not a kid movie to me. Because you talking about guys that they might not understand. Like, when we was coming up in school, we, you know, some of us read that, you know, the Icarus and all them. These kids wouldn't understand it.
Gotcha.
You know, like, you have to watch it, though. Because... Okay. At the end, they got a surprise at the end, too, though.
Do they?
Yeah.
Okay.
It wasn't a bad movie at all. It once you let it play, it'll start interesting you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because you'll like it.
Okay. Well, I was on my bias shit because this is me coming off of watching The Boys. I think it's another thing with Amazon, superhero shit.
The Boys was whack, though.
You know, yeah, and you know what I've been staying away from? But it's just like the cartoon movie on Amazon Prime. I forgot what it's called, and that shit was brutal. Now, that wasn't whack. The cartoon was dope, but, you know, you just going back and forth. And then have you been watching any DC shit?
No. Not at all.
Me neither.
Nothing.
Me neither.
None of it interests me no more.
So look, I'm gonna tell you like this. Let's go over real quick before we jump into the sports world, just in the television world. We're gonna come back and revisit. We need to talk about Snowfall.
Okay, we'll do that.
That last season, there's gonna be a sixth season, but I think it's gonna be the last season. But it went in a direction that I didn't want them to go.
Right.
But remember, we're post John Singleton now.
Right.
So it's all over the place. And it's stuff that happened in this season that I need to discuss, but I can't tell you before you see it.
All I know is
you're not gonna believe it.
All I know is somebody stole some money from Franklin.
Okay, you know that, right?
I know that. I know he was on the phone with the plug that he had since day one.
Uh huh.
The white guy threatened him. He hung up on him though.
Uh huh.
Then I ain't watch no more.
Yeah, you need to watch that shit from the whole thing, because it's like this. I've been watched it, but I watched it the hard way. I watched it week by week. Germ said he hates watching stuff week by week, but he binge watched it like in the last 2 days, okay? And he kept calling me back, and I was like, see, I couldn't tell you that. And he was like, damn, you mean to tell me this and this and this? And I was like, well, yeah, but I couldn't tell you though. And I wanted to so bad, right?
Right.
Because this shit took some directions that, man, you gotta check that shit out. You know what I'm saying? Because
right.
At first it'll seem like it's starting to annoy you, but the way that they tied that shit up with the season finale, that shit they pulled that shit together. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, because they was all over the place.
Yeah, they were.
For sure.
They were. It's unorganized. It ain't, you know what I'm saying? It ain't organized like it
used
to
be. What about, what's that boy name? Ghost. What about that little series? I don't know. They're supposed to start
up. Okay. Now, let me ask you this. Where did you leave off?
I ain't left off since, when he met his dad.
When who met whose dad?
When the basketball player met his dad. Which was
which
was his
okay,
plug.
Okay, okay.
I seen
okay.
that season.
Okay, you saw that. Well, okay. And then after that you didn't see Force. You didn't see Tommy, right?
Tommy came back?
Yeah.
I said I ain't see that then.
Yeah.
Okay. I didn't see that part.
They just had a season finale last week.
Ghost and them?
Tommy.
See, I ain't watched Tommy yet. I ain't watched none of Tommy.
Okay.
I still was on...
No, that's where you at. That's where it picked up from.
Okay.
Once the basketball player met his dad and all of that, and you finished that, that was the end of that.
I know. Okay. I'm just saying they ain't started back up.
No.
Now.
No.
So now I go to Tommy.
Now you go to Tommy.
No, I gotta go to Tommy.
It's called Force.
I know Tommy.
Showtime.
Ain't it on Showtime?
No, Stars.
Stars. Yeah, I can watch it.
Yeah, watch that shit, cause it's interesting, cause it's different than Power.
Okay.
It's Power for sure. It's Power. It's the Power Universe. But see, they in Chicago.
Yeah, he in a different city. I know that.
You feel what I'm saying? And he ain't got no business in Chicago. That's what makes the whole season, though. The whole thing is this motherfucker don't have no business being there. He's just being an asshole.
All right, watch it, damn.
Yeah, definitely. Like you're going to like him even more. That's what I'm telling you. You're going to like him even more. See, this is, you need to check it out.
Okay.
I gotta say, you're not going to be disappointed.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So, it's another show. This show I want you to check out. It's a show that's on Showtime. Okay? It's called Flatbush Misdemeanors.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to give you one reason to watch this show. I'm going to give you one reason. You know who Weebe is, right?
Yeah.
You remember Weebe?
Yeah.
This is his best role. And he's still the same nigga.
Okay.
But he's on there. He's not the main character. But watch that show just because of him, though.
Okay.
That shit is crazy. That shit is crazy, though. You got to check it out because it's kind of got... It's like, it's goofy. It's these little square-ass, lame-ass, sucker-ass niggas, right? And it's really about them. You feel what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But the way that the story maps out, watch that shit. That shit is crazy.
Okay.
I just started watching it like... Maybe 2-3 days ago, but I've already passed the season finale, cause that's it hooked me in.
Okay.
Another show I told you about, We Own the Night.
Mm-hmm.
All right, by the people that make The Wire.
Mm-hmm.
So far, it got Marlo in it, and it got the one nigga that was Brody's homeboy. Remember the brown skin?
Yeah.
He on that shit. Okay. You know what I'm saying? So check that shit out. It's there. It's just like that.
I missed.
But it's current though. It's not crack now. Like, you know what I'm talking about? It's the young niggas with these straps and his boy, just hair on and shit. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So check that shit out. And it's also about like, it's from the police standpoint, but it's also about like police brutality, because you know, I think Freddie Gray happened.
Mm-hmm.
In Baltimore, right?
Yeah.
So it's still up in the Baltimore world. You feel me?
Miss my show, man.
Which one is that?
HBO. What's the name of our show, man?
The Wire?
No.
Oh, you talking about Lovecraft Country?
I need some of that, man.
Yo, check this out, though. I got some soothing news for you. Hippolyta is the main character on We Own the Night. You dig what I'm saying?
What I'm saying, I think I seen some of that there. I think I seen some of that.
They only got one episode so far.
I was watching it and I turned it off.
No, watch that shit. Cause I can't.
But I thought it was some vampire shit.
I need you to answer this question for me, bro. It's the dude, when you check it out, We Own the Night, the it opens up with this main white cop. I don't want to say he's Irish, but he's something like that, all right?
Mm-hmm.
He's white than a motherfucker. But he's been in other movies where he was always a dick. I think he might have been on, what's that one zombie movie with Ghost when they were in Vegas? Remember, and it was on Netflix?
That was Batista.
Yeah. And they had to go into that vault or some shit.
Yeah, I know. I can't think of the name of the motherfucker.
Well, I think that dude that was a dick, remember? And the girl had to put him down.
Oh, the tall one, black hair.
Yeah.
I know who you're talking about. He had the suit on.
I,
I don't want to be mistaken, but I think that's the same guy. That's the guy in this shit.
Okay.
Cop, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Yeah, watch that shit. You know what I'm saying? And another show I want you to check out, this is different. It's on Amazon Prime, but you're a Fire Stick G, you know what I'm saying? It's called Outer Range. Mm-hmm. It's called Outer Range. This is a different movie, though. It's different. But the main character is the dude that played Thanos.
Okay.
All right? I think his name Josh Brolin or some shit like that, or Brolin or something like that.
Mm-hmm.
It's a different movie, though. This dude, he got like this ranch. This big. He got like a lot of acres, like a lot of big land. But in the back of the land, it's like it's a hole in the ground. You feel what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And the hole in the ground is almost like on some Twilight Zone shit.
Okay.
You feel what I'm saying? So boom, his sons get into some shit with the sons, the neighbors next door. The neighbors are trying to acquire some of their land. Sons get into this fight. He accidentally beats him to death. So the father throw him in this hole and shit, and all this shit drapes off into the story. You know what I'm saying? And it ends up that the hole somehow, it defies time. It's not like time travel, but it's something that's like, it's you gotta check that shit out.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Sound interesting. That's what I'm saying. I need interesting.
It's it's definitely different, man. Okay. That, and it's another show that Germ got me hip to, but it's, I watched, you understand? It's called From.
I heard about it.
It's a weird show, though. It's
some Key and Peele shit.
No, it's not funny. It's not funny. This is like horror shit.
Yeah, but they don't make funny movies though.
No. Hey man, whatever happened to when was the last time you saw a trailer for that movie? Nope.
I just seen the trailer.
Now which one did you see? Because it's like two or three.
I seen the one with what's her name?
Kiki Palmer.
She was outside. Or she was about to go outside, she was like, nope. And then, but I seen, it's more to the trailer.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I just can't tell you. I just seen somebody get sucked up, pulling off the dude from Get Out.
Right, yep.
I seen that.
Okay. Now, do you, from the trailer, deduce anything? Does anything make sense to you?
No.
Can you tell what's happening?
All I know, some aliens, I guess. I don't know.
All right.
It's weird.
It is. And it's like this. It's not like Outer Range, but it's not out of the ballpark from Outer Range.
Okay.
Outer Range started like that. They had some horses on the ranch that came up missing. So they split up on the ranch. One went south, one went west, and one went east to look, see if they could find where this horse ran off to. The father went west and ended up going way in the back, way in the back, and found this hole and shit. You know what I'm saying? And it was some weird, dreary shit. So, from what I gather from the different trailers that I saw so far, which were weeks ago, actually.
Right.
I haven't seen anything recently, but it's something to do with the horses. And I think that maybe these aliens might have an interest in the horses, or the horses might have a genetic, evolutionary history to the, maybe they're coming to get redeemed or something like that.
Right.
But that's kind of what I peeped so far. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
It's weird than a motherfucker. And I know that Jordan, and his name Jordan,
mm-hmm.
whatever Peele or whatever his name is,
right.
His movies are always underlining with some sort of a racial. So I can't put it together yet. You know what I'm saying?
I might go check it out.
Oh, I'm definitely gonna check it out. You talking about in the theater?
Yeah.
Why not? Just to get out. You know what I'm saying?
Ain't nothing else there. Trust me. These new movies
in the theaters. Yeah. I've been trying to watch the movie trailers, man. And honestly, I don't really see too much. I'm gonna force myself to watch the new Jurassic Park.
No, I like Jurassic
Park. I like Jurassic Park, and so I want to see.
I'm gonna watch it.
The reason why I want to check this one out is because they got all of the original characters in there.
Yeah.
So I want to check.
Did you see the last one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Now the last one was with Chris Pratt, right? And the Velociraptors,
right?
And the pterodactyls got loose and they were flying all over the park and stuff.
No,
like
that ain't the last.
That's not the last one.
That's not the last one. The last one is the one where they the island, the volcano was erupting. And they had to go try to save. They wasn't going to save something. They was going to take something and leave the rest to die. And the dude who had the stick with the moth in it,
yeah,
he was ill, but it was his people, like his, I don't know, nephew or somebody. You know, it's about money.
Yeah.
When they made a new raptor,
right?
The dude from Law and Order, the Chinese dude.
Yeah.
He made a new raptor. He put the raptor in the T-Rex together. I don't know if it ain't Jurassic World. That's the one you talking about.
Right.
I can't think of the name of it.
I know it's another one after that too.
Chris Pratt did two movies.
Yeah. He's in this one too.
Yeah, he did Jurassic World, then the next one. Just remember him and old girl in Jurassic World, you know what I'm saying? They was together. This one, she left. She was walking up on him like you the one who left.
Yo, man, I can't believe I missed this shit. I'm really tripping on this shit. So check this out. We're going to go over a little bit. We're going to change the subject a little bit. That covers our little news for the television, what to watch for the time being, movies. And we'll keep an eye on it. Check with us next week. We'll see if we can gather up some better views and shit. Trailers and what's coming out. But this shit here, man. You told me that Ice Cube and Scarface had a versus. Right?
Did you see it?
I'm looking at this shit, man. And I'm tripping because...
He over there sick, y'all. He is a hip-hop junkie. He's sick with it.
Yeah, and you know Cube is my fucking mans, right? That's my fucking mans, right? Yo, check this shit out. Hold on, bro. All them old G's. This is Mrs. Scarface. Hold up. This microphone ain't come on. Hold up. This is the Birdhouse Show. We're gonna be in here every Friday rocking out with you. Check it. Yeah. Some motherfucking women boys distracted. Cause it ain't nothing but the money blowing this camp. And it can throw me up to other ways there. So watch it and prepare for the hit man. Like with the black Indiago, take no shit man. You be fucked up, no trace. I'm a gorilla, my nigga that's coming. Yeah. Yeah. All I have is on my face. It's called Scarface. Nigga, get the fuck out of here. I missed this.
Yeah, man.
I'm gonna be up all night, yo.
Yeah.
Oh, shit, bro.
You messed up.
Money in the power? Money in the power?
Turn it off, man.
Oh, my God. Hold on, bro.
Don't do yourself like that.
This thing and I ain't from the South Side.
I'm from the Bronx. Start beatboxing on them, nigga? What?
Oh my God, are you fucking kidding me?
Peace, Jamal, do be cool. He reaches farther with his hands. Rehabilitated, the plan to be the man.
No.
The world is just as he's seen his life. Out of jail in 7 years, and he's happy that he.
No.
You can try to smoke an ounce of this while I pronounce this shit. Every belt looks good. Party crack in. Holy bad kid. We can smoke a gun. Down on both all these.
Wow. Dude, they got too many hits, man. Too many hits, bro. Too many hits, bro.
I went through it all the way. It's an hour and 3 minutes.
Man, I'm going through it. Trust me. Next week, I will have a full report. I'm going to have a report card next week. We're going to start doing report cards from now on.
Yeah, on the verses.
Yeah.
Just on the verses.
Yep.
Put them up on the wall.
Because you know, I need to hear your progress report on something.
Okay.
Cause you did check out that Stephanie Mills and Shaka Khan verses?
No.
Can you please?
No.
No, please. I'm begging you. No, Mo. I need you on this, man. Please. You need to. For real. No, Mo. You got to see Shaka Khan, man.
No.
Take my word for it, Mo.
I heard she was geeked up, but
she, man, Mo.
You got to see your boy. This.
Who that? You talking about Bobby Brown?
No, not Bobby. I love Bobby. I ain't gonna never talk bad about Bobby. You understand me?
Yes, sir.
Your boy, Adrian Broder. Did you see Adrian Broder?
No.
Oh man.
No.
Look that up.
What?
After the I think Earl Spence fight. Look what they had to do to this guy, man.
Adrian Broder. The fall of Adrian Broder 7 months ago. Hold on. Let me see if I can find this shit, yo.
After the fight.
After the fight?
After the fight. Just put after the fight, because that's when it happened. Should come up.
Okay. After the fight, Adrian Broner getting knocked down for the first time.
No.
3 years ago, 8 years ago, 4 years ago.
Let me see. Because you need to see this.
Yeah, I do. Yeah, I do.
For real, no, you really need to see this.
She's
not going to believe
this. This just happened last weekend, right?
Yeah. Well, a couple weekends ago.
You put your son to sleep? That's the one?
No. Let me see.
While you do that, I'm going to go to this new Pusha T shit. He got a couple of bangers on here. So that's going to serenade us while, you know what I'm talking about? My correspondent Mo pulls up this next song.
Right here.
Okay, let me know what the name of it is so I could.
Adrian Broner, intoxicated at the Spence versus Ugas fight.
Let me see your phone right quick.
The money counter ding, it's so exciting. Summertime, Winterfell, I'm the Night King, the Colgate Kilo. The hood needs whitening, we fish scale niggas. Like we all Pisces, your bitch in my bubble. Like I'm still typing, she hoping that you let her go. Like a kite string, your eco-friendly jewelers. You keep recycling, Cartier bust down. Just not my
yes, sir. Okay. I just emailed it to myself. Give me a second to pull it up.
Next to Brightling, wonder where this started from. The facts are frightening. Richard Price Flame gave birth to pipe dreams. Now we
wow.
Here. Beach with $1 million auto. Bring the cameraman, we can shoot our own knuckles. 812 matte black, looking like charcoal. I promise you, the floor plan's nothing like the model.
All right,
Hold on while I pull this up. Watch Adrian Broder. Oh, wait.
Hold up. All right, man. What's up?
Hold up. Before the young man starts spitting, let me change this screen so all my friends can see us. All right? No, let me change the properties of this shit, y'all. So, video is going to be Adrian Broder. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Transition. Stand the fuck by.
Well, this is AB yesterday, drunk as hell, barely able to stand yesterday at the Earl Spence you guys fight. And here he's with his pants hanging down to the goddamn floor while his ass hangs out. He's unable to walk, having to be carried under the damn shoulders by the young lady here and some friends come and assist him. It's like, why are your friends allowing you to drink this damn much? And they know AB got this damn problem. AB needs to seek some help. He doesn't need to return to the ring. Needs to check himself into an alcohol addiction program. If damn. There's drugs involved, which I clearly be thinking that there's some drugs involved in AB's situation, you need to seek help for boxing. Returning to the boxing ring, there's many people clapping their hands because AB's talk of coming back.
Right, man. No one sees AB back. Well, this is AB yesterday. AB fucking around and never enjoyed that money. It's hurt.
You see AB fights, he's not fighting. He's with his pants hanging down to the
goddamn floor while his ass hangs out.
That's your phone.
And for the dummies who probably come in like that movie about Black Brother AB and all this other dumb stuff, I carry that old fake black conscious shit.
Oh man, why that nigga play himself like that, yo?
And I'm gonna speak about.
Man, they clowning him on YouTube. Say the nigga went from worth $10 million to worth $13. Yeah.
Shit. So what you know so far about the draft, yo?
I know we ain't drafted.
I think we traded it.
Yeah, the Jets are doing great.
What all did they pick up?
They got a good-ass corner.
Mm-hmm.
And they got one of the best wide receivers, Garrett Wilson. And then they got a pass rusher, young pass rusher from Florida State, Jermaine Johnson. They was picking again. I ain't get to see who they pick, but they've been, you know, stocking up. They look like they're gonna be an up and coming team. So
I heard Pittsburgh signed
Pickett,
quarterback.
Pickett.
Yeah.
From Pittsburgh.
So someone's for Baker, huh? Is anybody going? What you think gonna happen with Baker?
Nobody want him.
Nobody. So we just basically stuck with him for a year, and then what?
I think everybody want us to cut him. They don't want to give us nothing. You know what I'm saying?
So I'm saying, what you think gonna happen with his career? Like, is you think he gonna be back in? You saw they made a stadium, what you call it, a statue of him in Oklahoma.
Okay, that's in Oklahoma.
Right. So what's gonna happen after this?
He nobody won.
Is his career done? Is he going to the fan league or something?
No, nah, he might get picked up, but nobody want him right now. You put yourself in predicaments. You know what I'm saying?
That's what I was trying to tell. Jerm was trying to defend him earlier. I'm like, he earned his spot, bro.
Yeah.
He earned his lot. Like, it ain't like, didn't nobody play him or try to do nothing to him. He earned the spot where he is right
All now. He had to do was just shut up. He could have been a backup. $18 million backup. Mm-hmm. He still gonna get the money, though. But, you know, it ain't about the money. Mm-hmm. That's what he say. Mm-hmm. But after you did them 7 commercials, you went downhill. You was out there eating the McDonald's boxes and all that.
And Progressive and all that shit. Talking about this is his house. Remember he used to come out with his own lawnmower and shit?
The code is 9. Yeah, you ain't got no code now.
Right, you ain't got, and release the hounds, bitch.
Your code is out of here.
Oh,
they got 3 quarterbacks. We don't need you, brother. Sorry. It is what it is.
Let me see if I can find some interesting news about the draft right quick. Point is clear and compelling. Our business's revenue will triple in the next year. Yeah, man. So you said you headed out to the spot though, huh? You gonna visit your spot tonight?
Yeah, I'm down here. Might as well.
I know that's right. I hope you do well.
I hope I do well.
I wonder, are these motherfuckers trying not to post nothing about the NFL draft yet or something?
It ain't over.
Yeah, but like usually they have some kind of news going on at all. They don't have nothing posted yet. They don't got nothing posted yet. That's cool. By the time Bobbito, Voice of the Young People, gets with us, I know Bob going to have something to tell me.
Yeah.
So where do you think the Browns is at though? Like right about now, like for the season coming up.
If Deshaun played, we the fifth best team in the AFC.
Say again.
If Deshaun Watson played the whole season, we'll be the fifth best team in the AFC.
Now, do you think he gonna get some suspension, some game suspended?
It don't look like it.
No.
Ain't nobody saying nothing. If he do, I still think we're going to be okay.
Yo, speaking of which, yo, did you check out that Ed and Katie Gallick went all the way to Houston to do a special on Deshaun Watson, talking to all the lawyers and accusers and shit? It was just on the news last night after the news. It's, you can probably find it on YouTube.
Why? I mean, why?
It, you know, he got a lot of haters on that shit, bro.
Yeah, but I'm saying, listen. Have you seen one of the women that accused him?
No.
Nobody's seen none of them.
Nope.
So what are we really talking about here?
That dollar bill, yo.
I'm telling you, like, come on, you like, use your fucking head. Everybody use your head. He was doing this for 10 years. He get a massage. And whoever was there that first time, capped him off. So he figured, you know, I'm paying an extra $30,000 for this shit. Because trust me, he paid for it.
You said my secretary, $30.
You know what I'm saying? And he kept doing it. And, you know, he ran into one that didn't want to do it. And she, oh my God, you know, blah, blah, blah. But you ain't showed your face. You ain't... I just don't understand the brutal part of it. What's the brutal part of it? That he asked for some head?
I don't really, man, you know how it,
if he wasn't Deshaun Watson and this shit was happening, do you think it would ever been reported? No. No. You would have not heard about Juju or my nigga Madman, you know what I'm saying, asking some bitches for some head at a massage parlor. Would have never happened like that.
Well, it was a happy ending.
You know what I'm saying? Now, it's a millionaire. He's a millionaire, you know what I'm saying? Like, come on, man.
And what do you really think he really did, though? Not to mention that shit really didn't come out until he had came out against the owner, for real, on some racist shit.
I don't think nothing. I mean, what? I'm telling you what happened. This shit weird, man. I just hate talking about people who got money and they're black. You understand? We stand in the spotlight. But Ben Roethlisberger went through this shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah. What's his name?
And they was holding his balls all the way out the door.
Come on, man. Ben's not like that. Why he like that then?
Right.
What did he really do? Because ain't nobody showed no bruises. Ain't nobody showed nothing.
He didn't really do nothing.
He ain't do nothing. They trying to get paid. Period. And I don't care. Like, you got to take it.
I'm saying, is that the economy that they have, though? That's a lot of motherfucking people, man. There's just everybody got the same. But that's why 22. I said, man. 22. Like I said, man. This shit didn't really happen until he kind of came at his the owners on some racist shit, though. Like, you know.
He wanted to leave. He wanted to leave. It ain't come out until he said he wanted to leave. So y'all, we gonna do this to what you doing that for? You gonna get paid? You know what I'm saying? Just like R. Kelly. Well, yeah, R. Kelly did it though. But
yeah, nah. I was tempted to bring up Bill because I was looking at this documentary on Bill. Ooh wee. You know what I'm saying?
Man, it's been 80 years, though.
Yes, it has.
Come on, man.
I don't know, man.
Listen, let's keep it all the way 100. Bill Cosby, right? Who do you think Bill Cosby learned that shit from? Hugh Hefner.
Yeah, that's true. Actually, it was in the documentary. That's where some of them hoes came from.
But I'm just saying, like, that was the biggest whole house ever. Playboy Mansion was the biggest whole house that never got raided, that nothing never happened, huh?
You think that has something to do with human trafficking?
Yeah. It's easy to get. Yeah, come on, man. You can hide 1,000 bitches in there.
And you talking about back then, too.
That's what I'm saying. Well, it wasn't hardcore on trafficking and nothing like that back then. Mm. They just started catching some, you know what I'm saying? They caught a couple people like, oh, man, we got to, like, really step our shit up. Mm-hmm. But, man, Hugh had bitches underground, on the ground.
Yeah.
On the bed.
Still.
Still. Come on.
Still.
But I'm just saying, so y'all looking at Bill like, you know what I'm saying? But it came from this white man. Mm. Bill Cosby ain't know that shit. Black people, we ain't do that shit. Mm-mm. We ain't putting shit in your drink just to get no ass. We really competitive about getting some ass. Like, you know what I'm saying? Any man.
Yeah.
He got and he that. Was Bill Cosby. Pudding pop guy.
That shit crazy, you know, man. That documentary is crazy. Because the thing is,
I just hate that black people, oh, I didn't know Bill was like that. And, you know,
yeah, put him on a pedestal and then try to knock him all the way down.
Yeah, like,
and
come on, y'all. Damn. That man, I don't believe he did it. I don't care if he did it. Let's just say that. I don't care if he did it, because
I don't care if he did it either.
It's been 80 years.
That's,
man,
still my, that's my cat.
He's still my guy. None of the motherfuckers on the Cosby Show, he did anything. He helped them. So come on, man.
Most of them.
Yeah.
On that one documentary, is two people that were on the Cosby Show that, and this one chick was at his neck too. Ooh, and she was, I'm like, ugh, bitch. But, you know,
it is what it is.
Whole another story.
Yeah, you can say whatever you want to about him, but he raised all of y'all on that show.
Pretty much, yeah.
If it wasn't for his name, y'all wouldn't have got nothing.
None of that shit. Nobody would have had a career down there.
That's most what I'm saying. People. Like,
and did you know they also said on that thing that Bill Cosby started the first, like, not him, but he got black people to do, like, he's got the first black stuntman in Hollywood, and he got them where they hired black people, like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, before it wasn't none. Right. Like, that's a lot of shit that he did, man, that a lot of people didn't even really know about, like, man, you know what I'm saying?
The Bill Cosby, listen, the Cosby Show, Different World, whatever other show, he had influence in all those shows.
Yeah, he did.
So let's look at Different World. Mm-hmm. What other black show that all black people watched really was supporting the HBCUs?
Just that one. That was the first one that ever did anything close to that.
Ever.
Ever. Ever.
You know what I'm saying? But
nobody, and almost after that, for real.
That's what I'm saying, but you ain't seen nobody else trying that, though. I mean, not even trying that, but, like, y'all keep saying, oh, we need to big up these HBCUs, but ain't nobody putting no shows out there like that. You know what I'm saying? What I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Bill did that.
Yeah.
He did that. And, you know, did he graduate from Temple?
Yeah.
Temple ain't even know HBCU, but he, you know what I'm saying?
And, you know, when the Cosby Show came out and School Days came out, that made everybody black want to go to college. That's why I think they wanted to tear that shit down. They ain't want too many, just getting too many.
He influenced people. Whatever, I'm saying, everybody got some kind of dumb shit in their past. You know what I'm saying? Everybody done some dumb shit. He just did dumb shit because he was rich. That's what rich people do, dumb shit. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm
saying? That's true. Look at Lori, what's it called, Aunt Becky and all of them motherfuckers that was paying to get their kids in school. With high accolades and shit, damn bitches ain't.
You know. I'm saying, look at T.I. I know. Look at T.I.
Yeah.
Rich. He buying bitches and doing it. And they ain't mad at him because he paying bitches just because they want to be freaks.
Shit. Look at Pusheyski.
Come on, man. It is what it is, man.
The more money you got, the more wild shit be.
Biggie, I mean, Puff, that's the truth. More money, more problem.
Mm-hmm.
For his gay ass.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway.
He supposed to be hosting.
He supposed to be a hoe on what?
He supposed to be hosting some show.
Oh.
Some awards show. I forgot which one. I don't stop keeping up with the shit. It ain't nothing black.
Never gonna be.
It ain't nothing black, so.
I mean, he was on stage with DJ Khaled and Megan Trainor. Stop playing.
Trying to pick up talent. Yeah, yeah. And then he called himself...
Two seasons.
What did he call himself? Brother Love?
Yes.
Do you love the brothers?
Two seasons.
Hey, man, I miss my one bitch, though. Did you watch that show?
Yes, I did.
You know which girl I like, don't you?
Who, Leah Janae?
Is that her name?
I think so.
Yes, that girl was cold.
She didn't win.
No, she didn't win, man. But I know that she's going to have a career. I know she's going to do something.
She's doing something right now.
Yeah.
You ain't heard nothing from neither one of the winners from either one of the shows.
No. No.
Neither one.
No.
I hear more about the runner-ups and the people that we did like that got eliminated more than them.
No.
More than
what
the
about,
winners.
What about you hip to that Snoop show?
I ain't watched it.
American Song?
I ain't watched it.
It ain't nothing. You don't have to.
Okay, don't waste your time.
Don't.
No. It's like watching The Masked Singer. Like, who watches The Masked Singer?
You know, speaking of which, though, here's the thing about Snoop. Let me just give Snoop a mention. You know he is the president of Def Jam right now, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then you know he signed, you know, when a Jerm always talking about Griselda, he signed Benny...
The Butcher.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Amongst a few other people. But did you know that he bought Def Row?
Yeah.
So this motherfucker is the president of Def Jam and owns Def Row.
Mm-hmm. All he got to do is just me and the deal right here.
Pretty much. He pretty much. Do you think he had anything to do with
Pop?
The whole any of it?
No. No. Snoop and Pop was. I mean, I think they had a little tension
at the end.
Yeah, but I'm saying if you look at the video Gangsta Party and just it wasn't Snoop didn't look like he was having fun. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Even though the song was.
Yeah.
But I'm saying, I think they mended that shit. I don't think he would have went that far as let me kill this nigga.
Right. Because
he ain't the next up.
Right.
I'm saying? Right. He was never the next up.
Right.
Biggie was the next up and Pac died.
Right. Right.
But if
right.
both of them died, then Jay-Z steps in.
Right. And here we are.
And here we are. And I believe in my heart, Puffy has something to do with that shit.
You think so?
Yeah.
Now, let me ask you this. On both ends of the scope or just on
both
one?
Ends.
For real?
You set both of them niggas up.
Oh, yeah? What about Suge? Do you think Suge had anything to do with it? Do you think he was in compliance?
No, I think Suge was just, he was just in the middle of it. And he ain't, you know what I'm saying? And they probably were like, don't kill Suge. They really wanted to kill Pac, you know what I'm saying? If Suge would have died, he would have died.
So Puff just like...
he had on a glow suit, man.
He's just out here like...
Yeah, killing niggas.
So, let me ask you one more question. It's relative, but it's not relative. But it is. All right. I'm going to watch your face. I had to put the camera on you. All right. Kim Porter. Mm-hmm. And that's her name? Mm-hmm. Was that?
Baby mama.
Yeah. And also, the ex-girl of Albie Shore.
Okay.
Okay. Did you hear anything about when she died that Albie Shore, he went online, he was saying he was scared for his life, he was crying and shit in the camera, like, she supposed to had this tell-all book that she was getting ready to publish, and Puffy was trying to get her to not publish the book, and then ended up where she was, like, suddenly sick, where it was like she wasn't really sick and all this other shit. So Albie Shore wanted to like disclose some information, but then he kind of backed down because of like, I guess, because Puffy, you know, I guess he connected. Did you ever hear anything about that?
No.
Okay, because I saw Albie Shore.
I seen him crying though.
Yeah, and that's what he was crying for. That's what he was talking about.
So who got the book though? Because they ain't find it.
that's a good question.
Who got the book? Because they didn't find it.
You think Quincy got it? One eyebrow cuz?
No. I don't think he got it.
I don't know.
It's gonna come out though.
I hope it do, because this is a while ago.
This shit is gonna be.
This is a while ago, Mo.
They lucky what's his name dead.
Who that?
Comedian. What was his name?
AJ.
Not AJ Jamal. The asshole. I can't think of his name, man.
Black guy?
Yeah. He can tell you like it is.
Robin Harris?
Paul Mooney.
Paul Mooney.
We lucky Paul Mooney.
Hey, man, we need a Paul Mooney book. Because Paul Mooney been in this shit since Cosby been in this shit.
Yeah. And that was his guy, you know. That
and you know what's one thing about Paul Mooney? Paul Mooney never really outed nobody.
Mm-mm. He'll tell the truth, though.
Yeah.
He like, you got to read between the lines, man. Nigga, like, he tell you the truth. You know what I'm saying?
I miss that nigga, man.
He never backed down. That's why they couldn't stand him.
It's not the same Hollywood anymore.
He wasn't a nigga pleaser.
It's not the same Hollywood anymore, man. Think about it. Will Smith smacked Chris Rock. Now, look, this is the reason why I'm saying that. This is two of Black Hollywood, most least street, least hood, least gangster. You know what I'm talking about? And I'm not taking away from being street smart or having, you know, talking about being street cred. You know, I know Pookie and Gusto and all of that.
Right.
But you know what I'm saying? My thing is this. On
Chris,
one hand,
wasn't Chris Rock big drug kingpin on Empire?
Frankie Gass.
Anyway, go ahead, man.
Yeah, he was Frankie Gass. And episode. Not only was he Frankie, that's why I told you I didn't believe that shit then. Not only that, he was also the dude that was on, remember I told you he was on Fargo?
Yeah.
With, what's my nigga, Cochise? What's my nigga from the movie that Germ did? See, Cooley High.
Yeah.
And they were gangsters on that show, but I didn't believe it. Well, now you see why. He didn't do nothing. And then you got your mother and your brother trying to come to bat for you, man. But at the same time, Will, hold on a second, man. Wait. Let me get this off my chest, man. This is the thing, though. Will was dead wrong.
Who?
Will Smith was dead wrong. I'm going to tell you why. Hold on. Listen to me. He know how much bigger he is than that's. He wouldn't have did that shit to T2 the motherfucking K Kirkland. He wouldn't have did that shit to God Tory. He wouldn't have did that shit to D Ray Davis. He wouldn't have did that shit to them niggas, man. I was like, man, you did that shit to a little nigga, man.
You know why he wouldn't have did it to them niggas?
Why?
Because them niggas would never be on the Grammy stage.
That's a good point, man.
They're not even Grammy nominated.
Well, not even relatively close, but the point is...
I know what you're saying, but I'm going to say this.
He got out on somebody smaller than him, though, to show off for his little breezy, though.
But he didn't, though. See, did you... The story. The storyline.
Yeah.
You know, they got into it before.
Yeah, I know about that.
Before that show, they leaked some audio. Did I tell you this?
Go ahead.
They leaked some audio and Will Smith asked him. Don't say nothing about, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, for real?
Yeah, they leaked the audio.
Oh.
Don't please, can you, you know, not say nothing about Jada or what's going on and just keep me out of it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I didn't know that.
And he went up there and called her G.I. Jane.
Oh, see, I didn't know that.
But my thing is, You don't know what that nigga going through, man. That nigga going through it, man.
Yeah, he is. But what I'm saying, though, this goes back to what I'm saying, though. Hold on, he didn't have to do it up there. Hold on, Mo. This is what I'm saying, though, because this is Black excellence, though. This is like the highest grossing two black, and then the most non-street shit. And he smashed out on this little nigga. Why he ain't smashed out on August Alsina?
He didn't want to kill him.
So what? Why he ain't seen him? Why he ain't smacking?
I don't know. He did.
I'm saying, he did Ali Boumbaye his ass. And remember, he worked out a lot to play the role of Muhammad Ali. But I'm saying, those push-ups for what? Those push-ups for nothing. You still let August Alsina smash out on your girl, and I still think it's weird that was the son on Menace to Society.
Look. If somebody smashed your girl, right, and you know she tell you whatever, and then y'all out somewhere, and this nigga he running his mouth, and he, you know what I'm saying, he disrespectful. What you gonna do? You gonna do exactly what he just did, even though it wasn't really disrespectful because he's a comedian. But all I'm saying is we don't know his mind frame. You know, he laughing and joking, and she wasn't laughing. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's true.
And he looked at her, she probably like,
Yeah. But
you tell he had to turn into John Q, man. He had to turn into John Q.
That was a sucker move, man.
It still would have been either way.
But Chris Rock, now I don't know about the audio, because he was wrong, because he did that shit. All right, first off, you know they did Madagascar together. You know, he was the zebra and she was the hippo on Madagascar. Like, you know, I know your kids are grown.
Yeah, I watched it.
But I'm saying, and then they had all of that history with him clowning, you know, picking at her at previous little shows and shit. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And then if you told him, but see, the audio I didn't know about.
Yeah, that leaked audio, he can't sue him. Mm-hmm. Is he actual? But my thing is, you just... I don't really believe he smacked him.
You think it was staged?
Yeah. I believe it was staged. Let me tell you why I think it was staged. Somebody ran this across me, and it made perfect sense, so I'm gonna share it with you. You at the Grammys.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Mm-hmm. Motherfucker just got smacked. And you heard something go off like that, didn't you?
Mm-hmm.
You heard it like he smacked the shit out of him, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
You in Hollywood. There's only one angle of that smack.
That's true. That's true.
Now, nigga, if T.I. would have smacked the shit out of somebody, nigga, they'd have had that bitch on this angle.
Yeah.
They'd have had it on this angle. They would have slowed the motherfucking slap down.
Yeah.
It was one angle. Right after that smack, he sold out in 3-4 states.
Oh, he did. You right about that. And his tickets, the prices like
200
skyrocketed. They say there's like 200% between $400 and $600.
Yeah, but they went up 200%.
Yeah, you right about that.
Tony Rock sold out.
You right about that.
He up there acting mad you can't fight neither.
Yeah.
If your big brother can't fight, you can't neither. So shut the fuck up.
He gonna try to act like a big man.
No, he was making money. They were all making money now.
You're right about that shit.
He just helped you.
You're right about that shit.
Come on, man. You know they would have showed the spit hit the nigga forehead after he smacked him. They had one angle, which was the back angle.
Now keep my wife's name out your fucking mouth.
They had one angle of that. Like, come on, man. You couldn't even, the first time he said it, you couldn't even see him. And then they zoomed in on him. Come on, you know they got better cameras. You know what I'm saying?
Man, come on, cut it out.
But I'm saying Chris Rock was okay. Like, that's.
And not to mention, we're all like the little TMZ people and shit that be jumping out, like getting little, you know what I'm saying?
If he would have smacked Chris Rock like he threw that, Chris Rock would have hit the flow.
Little pokey.
He would have hit the flow. For real.
That's like he said on CB4. He was like, let us play in the club. He's like, nope, he'll slap me.
Yeah, but I'm just saying, he would have hit the flow.
Yeah,
but trust me, he would have hit the flow.
Yo, you got any battle rap news that you want to forecast? We can get back to it next week, but like, you know, let's set it up.
Check out Prestavia versus Danny Myers. Rosenberg Raw versus Ill Will. They got Kings versus Queens. It might be going down tonight. I ain't for sure. I think it is tonight. Kings versus Queens.
Okay.
Other than that, we'll get into it next week.
Okay.
My nigga.
Bet. And then, so, last.
Oh, hold on. One more thing.
Yeah.
Easy to Block, Captain. You know, he's one of the characters in Bel Air.
Right.
He's the main bully from Philly. That's Easy to Block, Captain. He's a battle rapper.
But he really from Philly, right?
Yeah, he really from Philly.
Okay.
He a battle rapper. He signed a deal with Lil Flip.
With Lil Flip?
Yeah.
Hell no. Now, when was the last time I saw Lil Flip?
Where?
At the Bone. When he at the Bone?
Yeah, and right after that, he been at all the battle rap events.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, because you still think he's like the freestyle king?
Yeah, but he be there. They you know, showing him love. Like, he be talking to niggas. He be there with Cassidy, all them niggas.
Oh, word?
Yeah, they just had something like, because, you know, there's so many leagues. It's URL, RBE, but RBE had some little, like, event, and he was there. And they interviewed him after on 15 Minutes of Fame. But, yeah, he signed a deal with that dude.
Okay.
We got an album coming up, too.
Cause you know, Don't Caffeine
They got a spot where you can put your podcast, like you can upload your podcast. Okay, because look, because we're getting ready to we're going out on Apple, iTunes. We're gonna have people that can subscribe to the show, so we're gonna need that content.
Okay.
All right. I set everything up now, so we're gonna be going over like, you know, like about 8 or 9 different things. We're going over Twitch, we're going over Pandora, Spotify, iHeartRadio. See, we're hitting big time now.
Do you see these fucking views? Yo, hold up a second, man. Yo, do you see these fucking views? Yo, this is where we at, man. You know what I'm saying? So check this out. Yeah, we're going out on, I'm gonna have everything done up. I'm gonna graphically. So I'm gonna get your name. I'm gonna make you some shit where it's gonna be like your name and then the like the Twitter logo thing and all of that. Did you see Elon Musk just bought Twitter?
Yeah.
What do you think about that, man? Okay, let me tell you. I watch a lot of news. A lot. All right. Now I watch this. I just do a spotlight on urban entertainment. Hold on, let me know when the G's get in. Yeah. So anyway, all right. First off, Elon Musk, as soon as he bought Twitter, you know, the first tweet that he put, he said he's buying Coca-Cola and he's putting cocaine back in it. Second off, he's one of those free speech people that say crazy things. That like Donald Trump used to do. Right. Remember Donald Trump got suspended off of Twitter?
Yeah.
Well, guess what? Elon Musk owns it now. So Donald Trump's gonna be back at his shit. Not only that, Elon Musk has a lot of business dealings with people in China. And China is blocked from Twitter. So if you're talking about how like the Russians were doing collusions and fake news through social media to change and alter the elections, watch what happens now.
Right.
So Twitter, if Donald Trump,
Twitter is big.
And Elon Musk is smart. And he's also talking about buying a McDonald's and fixing all the milkshake machines.
What? You know what I'm saying? What's wrong with
him? Well, you know the milkshake machines are always down at McDonald's.
Yeah, that's true. They ain't like rallies though. I drop a dime on them niggas. I swear to God.
Yo, did you see Joe, Uncle Joe. You know, Uncle Joe asked for another additional $33 billion for Ukraine aid. Here's my thing with that. They just gave him $2.8 billion. We're suffering over here, man.
Right.
We ain't really got it all like that. They still didn't do no student loan forgiveness shit yet. You know what I'm saying? Ain't nobody really on their feet yet like that.
Right.
Here where we are. You know what I'm saying? And right. I understand. And not only that, Ukraine has a lot of allies over there, right next door. Wouldn't it take longer to get shit from here over there than it would be over there? It's an ocean between us.
Right. I don't know, bro.
But the only thing is, what I'm saying, though, it's not good for Uncle Joe because Uncle Joe is asking for an additional, but this time he's saying $33 billion to keep these guys out of this shit. You know what I'm saying? Then they fronted on the infrastructure bill. You know what I'm saying? They cut off the PUA shit. They cut off the motherfucking extensions to the food stamps, emergency food stamps. They cut off the unemployment shit. You know what I'm saying? So where is this coming from?
No idea, bro.
And who's voting against it? I ain't heard none of the motherfuckers that be, you know what I'm saying, raising all of that ruckus, you know what I'm saying? So that's just, you know, I'm not going to get too political, man. I'm just saying that this shit is getting crazy.
I know it is, bro. Gas hurt niggas more than anything right now.
Yo, shit, a gallon of milk is like $5.
Wow.
Food is so high, you know what I'm saying? It's like this shit is crazy, man.
Yeah, it's life. I don't know, they like, it's a shortage on chicken. What the hell we stop? Who eating right. all the damn chickens, man?
Hey, man, they remember they said they was trying to move on to the thighs now. Right. Shit like that. And I'm like, what?
Nigga, if you don't give me my motherfucking leg.
Nigga, if you don't cut that shit out.
Right on.
So, yo, check this out. Let me mute this bitch, right? Skip this ad. I'm gonna walk us up out of here, man. I want to put you on your good foot. You understand what I'm saying? You about to go down to the spot, and you gonna put us together.
Put us together.
My man. All right, well, check this out. You've been checking this out. This is the Birdhouse Show. We're going out on the YouTube channel this week. Next week, we're going to expand to a few more things. We're going to also include extra content, and we're going to include a subscription. You know what I'm saying? For those that want to get to the nitty-gritty.
Right on.
Also, we're getting ready to pull up some merchandise, T-shirts, Scullies, and all of that. That's on the way.
Okay.
You feel me?
Right on.
So check this out. I'm your host, Jay Bird. I got my man's Big Mo is in the house with me tonight. Yo, thank you for joining me.
What it do?
Thank you for coming down to this bitch. You know what I'm saying?
Right on.
Yo, pop your collar one time. We're going to holler at y'all next week. And till then, peace.
Yep.
Legs in the tank, your peripheral. It's a full moon in the middle of the day. Got them wolves out rocking little Cartier. Got trapped down pat like the masquerade. Know a few rebels ain't gonna see their next birthday. Tell them young niggas round for you, gon' knock some down. That they gon' shoot, then shoot some. We better.